Welcome back to the Real Estate Rat Pack Radio Show with Chris, Joe, and Rob. The crew is taking your calls, so dial in at 1-800-808-5548.
And welcome
we're back.
You know, one thing is time flies when you're having fun.
Oh, my gosh.
So two items. Number one, we got a great show. We're talking all about down payment assistance.
Yes.
All the different programs, et cetera, out there. We got some great guests. We are going to talk with Ruby, who is actually a realtor also and knows a lot about the down payment assistance programs. But first, we have a caller right now.
We have a caller.
Diane, how you doing?
Hi, I'm doing good, and you?
Yes. We got Diane. Okay, she's there. I can hear her. We always play with headphones here. We have to put on headphones so we can hear you guys. So all of us start scrambling when there's a call to grab headphones. Diane, are you there?
Yes, sir. I'm here.
Yay. All right. Glad to have you on the show today, Diane. What question do you have for our guests?
Well, I wanted to know that in order to qualify for the down payment assistance program, what were my credit scores? Like, what do they need to be?
Well, you know, Ruby, you're there. Jump on the mic.
Typically, the minimum credit score is going to be a 640. I know that some lenders out there will tell you that you can qualify with a lesser score for their loan programs, but for these down payment assistance programs, you're definitely looking at a 640.
And I would concur. I would say most of the time it's a 640.
Mm-hmm.
You know, you have a couple of them that you can program, you can qualify at a 620. You know, I tell everybody is if you're looking at qualifying anything below a 620, there's different down payment requirements associated with it, different requirements, period. And generally speaking, the box is so small. A lot of individuals don't qualify, unfortunately.
Right, and for the most part, if you do qualify under 620, there's going to be other hoops of fires, so to speak, to cross through throughout the process, which makes it tremendously stressful.
I love that analogy, hoops of fire.
great imagery there.
Yeah. So 640, that's kind of the magic number even for the down payment assistance programs. That's kind of a magic number across the board in most home loans,
that is
as
correct.
We're seeing. So, shameless plug here, I would say, we have folks at my office, ImproveMyCreditUSA.com. Whether you know your scores or not, whether you think you might be in a good position score-wise, give us a shout because we'll go through the process of seeing where you're at. So you know, hey, you're at a 680, you're good. You're good to go. We'll get you over to Ruby to go out looking for a house and Shad as well.
I'll say, no, I think they'd have to go to Chris first for the approval.
Now that is an excellent sign, by the way.
Sharp realtor there. Yes. Yes.
We've got to educate Joe on the process.
Yes. that's an expert. She goes, I'm not getting in the car.
Give me an approval, we'll get in the car.
Time is money.
Well, that makes sense because really, do you want to waste somebody's time and show them things, get them all excited about a house, and they can't buy it?
Oh, I would absolutely agree. Well, Diane, does that answer your question, by the way?
Yes, it did. Thank you.
Likewise. Thank you very much.
Well, we have a great show, guys, and we have a lot of experts in the studio. We actually have a tremendous amount of expertise just in it with a few folks here on down payment assistance. That's our topic for the day. So if you're out there, you're looking at buying a home and you're considering a first-time home purchase, that type of thing, it's a great question to ask, a great question to know. Is there money out there to assist in the process of getting into that first home? That's a big deal, and that's what we're chatting about today. 800-808-5548 is our number.
By George, he got it right.
He got it right this time. And, you know, we have Ruby right now. We've been speaking, obviously, with Shad prior to this, going over some of the initiations of the initial products out there, talking about the Southeast Texas Housing Corporation. Now we're talking with Ruby, actually. And, you know, one of the things that we want to talk about, obviously, is one of the things that Shad said was find a good realtor who knows what they're talking about.
Oh,
you fit that bill.
Rockin' Ruby Miranda.
That actually is so true because being on the front lines, I deal with a lot of first-time home buyers, and they come to me, and I'm amazed, blown away that they've dealt with other realtors who have never mentioned to them these programs. And the thing is that they need these programs. I had a young couple last year. They were only qualified up to $65,000. They had a 4-year-old and a 1-month-old baby. We're going and seeing these $65,000 houses, rough houses. And I feel bad because, you know, I'm looking at their children. How are they going to crawl on the floor in these houses? And it's crazy. So I said, hey, you know, they're approved like through a big bank. I got the lender that I work with. Got him on the phone, put them on there. I, you know, after kind of talking a little bit, I knew that the hands down they would qualify. Got them approved. By the time I got back to the office, looked up some more houses, found one property, $89,000 property, which, of course, you know, you're thinking that's totally over where they need to be. But with after negotiations, getting some closing costs, and after getting a $20,000 grant program, these people came in under budget. So their payment was well under $600 because their loan amount was close to like $67,000 or something.
Wow.
And you know what? To this day, that was 3 years ago, that I am their realtor of choice. They refer me friends, family, cousin, you know, because they got some free money. They want everybody to get that money.
Well, and you know, this is such a great point here. And this touches on what Chad was talking about earlier. And I wanted to bring out was the philosophy behind these programs. What's the point? Because that's the people right there. That's the people we're talking about. You have two kids that are either going to grow up in a really nasty house, you know, nothing in a bad setting possibly, or an apartment complex. And, you know, apartment complexes have become long-term housing for a lot of folks, and they were never meant to be long-term housing. The crime rates and everything else around that, it's just not, you know, not that there's not good apartments out there. I don't want to, you know, downplay that.
Yeah, the apartment association can be calling any
right?
minute now.
But they were never meant to be long-term family solutions. That wasn't the point. So that's the family right there that these kind of programs
are
meant to
help. And I would say it really does, because the private home ownership goes such a long way for the community, for the person, for the family. And so it doesn't just affect the parents. It affects the children. It affects the neighborhood they move into. When you have a neighborhood where you have more home ownership, that pride of ownership shows. They take care of their yards. They don't have the trash, the debris, versus when you have a neighborhood that is predominantly rentals, you have that, I don't care, it's the landlord's problem. So when you're able to take this tool where somebody who might not have a big chunk of money saved to buy a better quality house, and now here you are able to educate them and offer them these programs that they would not have otherwise known about, because these like this particular couple was not necessarily internet savvy. They were young. They had worked with a realtor before. They had specifically asked her, is there anything out there for me? She's like, you don't want to mess with all that. You know, and you have
not
these
the right
out
answer.
There. I know, and it's crazy.
You don't know what you don't know.
When they look at me and tell me, gosh, Ruby, you're so nice. And I'm like, well, thanks. You know, I mean, shouldn't everybody be nice and educating them and want the best for them? But the pride that they have in their home is just phenomenal.
Well, you know, and one of the things I'd say, it's funny, in this show, it seems like every Saturday I have an agent that sends me one of their newsletters, and it's always appropriate for the actual show. One of his newsletters today says, can I afford not to buy? And it's really neat because it says here, buying versus renting, okay, a $900 payment on a mortgage, which is about $700 of interest, versus an $800 in rent, okay? Assuming a 28% tax bracket on an annualized basis, this doesn't include down payment assistance or anything, this is just buying, right? You will be saving $8,448 a year by buying a property versus a cost of about $1,150 on the rental side of things.
And not even taking into account that rent's going to go up.
That is correct.
Have no control over that.
And this will, it goes on to say this doesn't include the equity that you build in the property, which is now a wealth building factor, something that Chad talked about a bit earlier today. So, I mean, that's one of the things is now if you can couple that with down payment assistance, it's sort of a no-brainer, and it's a win-win when it comes to our potential clients out there.
So, Ruby, I want to ask, because as I said at the beginning of the show, I know very little about the whole process. Who is, you know, you gave us a great example right there of one couple. Who is the person out there that should be asking, do we have any down payment assistance programs?
Well, definitely if you're a first-time home buyer, ask, because it doesn't hurt to see if you qualify. You may not qualify, but gosh, if you apply and you do qualify, that's a wealth of information. So and not only is it a wealth of money, it's a wealth of information because you get your education courses. And then the typical home buyer is going to stay in their house, 5 to 7 years is what all the statistics say. So some of these programs that have you in there for 10 years, 3 more years past the average time is really not that bad, and you have instant equity. And actually, I know that the payback on some of these have stipulations where you might not have to pay them back, depending on, you know, growth. And don't get me started. That's the mortgage side of it, so I don't know all that part of it. But there are stipulations. But still, if you're only talking 3 years past the average 5 to 7 years, it's great. Get some money in there. I have people, I think the highest priced home that I've sold on this program was a $180,000 house, because you have two different types of buyers out there that I find. You have the ones that can save the money, but that payment, they got to keep it low. Their DTI is low. They don't make a lot of money. They have their debts and everything like that. So they got to keep their DTI real low so they can't afford a lot of house, but yet they can save the money.
And DTI is debt to income.
Oh, sorry, debt to income ratio. Sorry. And but then with the with the other consumers, you have the other type of consumer that they're like, say, the $180,000, they can make that monthly payment, no problem, but they just can't save the money. You know, and so here you have these people that, I mean, they're paying rent somewhere. Everybody's paying rent somewhere. You're living somewhere. So might as well be in your own home. It might as well be in something that's not only within your budget, but is better for you. And you have all these benefits and education that come along with it.
Awesome.
I wish she'd get
agree.
Some enthusiasm about this, you know?
I know. She does.
I'm
she
really
does.
Passionate about home
you need to dial up the energy level a little bit there.
I love DPA. I love down payment assistance programs. They're phenomenal.
So tell me,
we love
tell
acronyms
me,
also.
Yeah. I know. I'm working on it.
Yeah, and I do caution people always when you have an acronym. We're so used to talking in acronyms. Sometimes you have to stop and go, oh, we've got consumers out there who have no idea what we're talking about.
I should totally know better. I actually just took a class on this on Thursday. So I'm
usually there to chime in. Tell me, what other kind of programs you've worked with? You've talked about that one couple. Tell me some other programs you had some success with.
Well, I've worked with the City of Houston 19,500 Down Payment Assistance Program. Baytown has a similar program that I've worked with. Brazoria County has a similar program. Galveston County has a similar program. So I've worked in all these counties with those programs. I've done the five-star program. Love the five-star program. I think they kind of, MCC, the majority of my people get MCC. I get, you know, I mean, it's few and far between that can't qualify for that, because I like the way the banker that I work with, the way he phrases it. These programs are kind of tiered. You have the 20,000 for the really low income, you have the five-star for the mid income, and then a lot for the little bit for the slightly higher income, the MCC, the five-star, I mean, the MCC is going to kind of fit them. So either way, I mean, apply for these programs, because you never know if you're going to get the 20 or the tax credit.
The worst I can tell you is no. Right. That's the worst I can tell you. Or you can save thousands of dollars a year.
Because you ask not.
Oh, and the beauty is when you qualify for one of these down payment programs and you get that MCC alongside of it. So not only are you getting money up front to help you with that down payment, but you're getting money year after year after year for the life of the loan.
Yep. So you can do a combination of those programs.
Oh, yes.
Oh, absolutely.
Yes. And there's other programs out there. But
what are you waiting for out there?
Hey, you know what?
We got two realtors here ready to help you.
Chomping at the bit. You know, we're coming up on a break, and we want to make sure you guys out there listening, if there's anybody out there that's in an apartment right now, I'm telling you what, you should be on the line talking to these guys, because we've got the expertise you need. 800-808-5548. Give us a call, and we'll get those questions answered about what programs apply to you and what we can do to get you into a house.
Absolutely. And we're going to be right back.